A few months back, my friend Lane came to visit, and we headed out to the Kandt House Museum. This was the house of Richard Kandt when Rwanda-Urundi was part of German East Africa. Kandt established Kigali as the administrative capital. His house is now a natural history museum. I last visited about 15 years ago when the displays were mostly plywood and plastic animals, so I was curious to see how it looks today. We were kind of intrigued when we entered and were asked if we'd like to pay 2,000 extra to see the reptiles. Something about a crocodile. Naturally, we said yes. As with most museums in Rwanda, we weren't allowed to take any pictures inside, but there wasn't really much you'd want to take a picture of. It's a bit shinier than it was 15 years ago, but it's still mostly just text on the walls and nothing to interact with. I definitely wasn't feeling that enthusiastic about it. That was until we stepped outside. Yeah, okay, first impressions weren't great. Can you spot the crocodile? Because it took us a while. But the main attraction is the snake house. It feels a bit like a curiosity shop from another era, but it's certainly got some interesting inhabitants. This is a boomslang. Not often deadly, but even a scratch can cause serious injury and internal bleeding. This is a forest twig snake. It has a hemotoxin venom that can be fatal to humans, but bites are so rare that an antivenom hasn't been produced yet. Then it was time for the main event, and I was totally starstruck. This utterly gorgeous creature is the black mamba. It's really sad because every year hundreds of house snakes get decapitated by overzealous housekeepers. House snakes are completely harmless and help keep down the rodent population, but because house snakes are black, people freak out and think they're poisonous. The actual black mamba isn't black at all. It's more of a slight green tint. The only part that is black is the inside of their mouth, which is as ink black as their eyes. Though whoever lived to explain that must have been a magician, as the black mamba's bite is 100% fatal if left untreated. A very painful way to go. But it looks so cute. Honestly, I never thought that I would meet the cast of Kill Bill. Next door was this amazingly coloured rhinoceros viper. It took me a minute to work out where its head was. Definitely wouldn't want to step on one of those. They're also poisonous, by the way, cytotoxin. Everything in this reptile house could kill you. Except maybe this guy. Oh, and this guy. He's just a rock python. But he'll crush your bones. And back to the toxic ones. A gaboon viper that just looks like a pile of leaves. It's also really fat. I asked if it had just been fed, and they said no, it always looks like that. Still, I hope they count the kids on the school trip before they leave. Honestly, I just think these snakes are the most amazing creatures ever, and what a privilege to get so close to them. When we headed back outside, it was feeding time for the museum's Nile crocodile.
Nope, you just keep eating. Lost your dinner to a giant bird, mate. Sorry.
I wasn't really expecting very much from this museum, but meeting that black mamba is my favourite thing in Kigali ever. I would buy a season pass for that. So if you're looking for something to do to kill an hour or two on a sunny afternoon, go check out the Kandt House Museum.